I use BitLocker. Are my backups encrypted? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. Leo, when you do backups on a source drive that is BitLocker encrypted, what status of your files gets backed up? In other words, if you want to restore a file from your backup image, will your backup image have your files stored in the clear? Or will your backup image have your files stored in a garbled, encrypted state? Absolutely, this can get confusing very quickly, but most backup tools backup files in their unencrypted form. That's convenient, since that's what I recommend. The tools I recommend do it that way by default. But there are situations and choices that can cause your data to be backed up in its encrypted form. In this video, I want to walk through some of the ways that things can be both stored and encrypted for both disks and files, and then which of those your backup process might be choosing to back up. So a disk is comprised of sectors of information. A sector is just a fixed size block of data. I'll use 512 bytes as an example. When information is written to a disk, it's broken down into sector-sized chunks. So, for example, this is a 22-sector disk. If each is 512 bytes in size, then the disk has a capacity of 11,264 bytes of data. I did not say it was a very big disk. The 9 red squares, 2, 3, 4, 7, 16, 17, 18, 21, and 22, indicate sectors to which data has actually been written. This represents 4,608 bytes of space that's actually used by data. That leaves 6,656 bytes of free space. Now, note that the disk itself has no idea what those sectors contain, other than the fact that these contain data and those don't. This will be important in just a moment. Now, let's look at our disk and identify some of the files thereon. There are 4 files on this disk. File 1 is in sectors 2, 3, and 16. File 2 is in sectors 4, 18, and 22. File 3 is in 7 and 17, and file 4 occupies only sector 21. When you access a file, say by opening up that file in a program, like say Microsoft Word, the operating system handles locating and figuring out where all those various sectors are, and then returns them in a single, coherent way. While the sectors are technically still there, the program using the file sees only a single file full of data. All right, now let's talk about encryption. BitLocker and other forms of whole disk encryption encrypt by encrypting every sector on the disk. There's no knowledge of which sectors hold what, or even if they're holding data or not. Each sector is simply encrypted. When you access a file, again as we did before, the operating system handles, well, locating the various sectors that contain the file, decrypting each sector, and then once again returning it all in a single coherent way. Similarly, if you were to write the file to disk, the operating system handles figuring out which sectors that file is supposed to be written to, and then encrypting each sector as it's being written to the disk. Now, from your perspective, the file is unencrypted, since all the decrypting and encrypting happens at the sector level as the file is being read and written from and to the disk. Finally, we could talk about backing up. As you use your computer, you see only unencrypted files. The data on disk is decrypted before you see it when reading, and it's encrypted after you save it when writing. This makes it easy for all programs to access the files on your hard disk without regard to whether or not the disk is encrypted. Those programs are just operating on files, like they always have. Now, most backup programs behave exactly the same way. They operate on files that appear unencrypted. Even an image backup program operates without knowing or caring that the data on disk might be encrypted. It sees files, just like you do, in their unencrypted form. Hence, it backs up the files in their unencrypted form. Now, as with every rule, there's an exception. To read the files on your disk, your backup software needs to understand how the disk is structured. That means it needs to understand the file system that's being used. This is also known as the format of the disk, such as NTFS, FAT32, or many others. If the backup software doesn't or can't understand how the data is organized on the disk, maybe something got corrupted, or maybe it's a file system that the backup program just doesn't understand, it may offer to do what's called a sector-by-sector backup. This backs up the entire disk surface without regard to what it contains, or whether or even how it's encrypted. This type of backup is also called a clone, and you can also choose to perform this kind of backup manually if you want to. It's often used for forensic data recovery since it includes unused sectors as well as the exact sector-by-sector layout of the disk. In this case, if the disk is encrypted, a sector-by-sector backup backs up encrypted sectors. If the disk is not encrypted, a sector-by-sector backup backs up the unencrypted sectors. Now, so far, I've assumed you're signed in and are running your backup software from within Windows. If your drive is BitLocker-encrypted, because you're signed in, the files on it are accessible in their unencrypted form. If you boot from your rescue media, which launches a copy of your backup program, and you attempt to make a backup image of your BitLocker-encrypted drive, we have a problem. You haven't signed into your PC, so the drive has not been mounted and cannot be decrypted. There are two options. Some backup programs will notice that the drive is BitLocker-encrypted, and they may ask you to provide the recovery key. If you're able to do that, that allows the backup program to mount the drive and back up the unencrypted data just as if you had been signed into Windows. The other alternative? Back up the drive sector by sector. The first gives you unencrypted backups. The latter will be encrypted. Now, if you have an unencrypted backup, you can do what you like with it. You can restore it, you can extract files from it, whatever. The results will also be unencrypted. But what happens if you have a sector-by-sector backup containing an encrypted BitLocker drive? Well, there's not a lot you can do with it other than restore it in full. Most often, that's enough. For example, if you swap out a failed hard drive, that's exactly what you want. Once you reboot and sign in, the BitLocker drive is mounted and you can access it normally just as before. Unless your backup program can recognize and accept a BitLocker recovery key to decrypt the image, you cannot mount it using your backup tool to extract individual files. So, what have I got? The easiest way to determine what kind of a backup you have is to try to look inside. In many cases, that's as simple as just double-clicking the file containing the backup. If you can see the contents without specifying a key or a passphrase or anything else, then it's unencrypted. If you can't, you may get a message about the contents being unrecognized or a message that the contents are encrypted. Again, in some cases, the backup software might be smart enough to recognize the encryption and ask you for that recovery key or passphrase. What about backup program encryption? In other words, many backup programs allow you to password protect your backups. This encrypts the contents of the backup files created by the backup program. This has nothing to do with BitLocker or other types of encryption on the disk that you're backing up. It's just a way to secure the backups themselves. You'll need this password to access the backup later and either restore it or access its contents. All right, what about encrypted files? If you've got individually encrypted files, say you've got a password-protected zip file or you're using Cryptomator, nothing really changes. In this example, we're looking at our sectors again. File 1 has been encrypted by some external program. That each sector in this diagram says encrypted is actually a little bit misleading because in this case, it's the file, not the individual sectors that have been encrypted. The entire file was encrypted before being written to disk, and it'll be encrypted when it's read from disk. Everything we've discussed so far remains the same. If your backup program is performing a sector-by-sector backup, then you'd have to do a full restore in order to access the files. If your backup program is doing a more traditional file-by-file backup, then all the files are accessible. But the files that were encrypted individually remain encrypted individually. Interestingly enough, those encrypted files have the distinction of being encrypted twice. Once by whatever tool you use to encrypt them, Zip, Cryptomator, whatever, and again by BitLocker when it was written to the disk. Doesn't matter. So, bottom line, yeah, backup, of course. I recommend actually that you backup your data in unencrypted form and then secure it some other way for your security. This could be keeping it in a physically secure location, such as an external hard drive placed in a safe, or using a different form of encryption, possibly that encryption provided by your backup program. Having these two different kinds of encryption reduces the risk of both of them failing for some reason simultaneously. Your original data stored in encrypted form and your backup of that data stored in a differently encrypted form are less likely to both fail at the same time. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/179503. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.